Today, we're going to be diving into the Molten Salt Reactor Experiment, or MSRE for short. A groundbreaking experiment that showcased the potential of molten salt fuel nuclear reactors. In this tutorial, we'll be showing you how you can bring MSRE back to life in your own computer. To do so, we'll be using probably the most advanced model of the MSRE in the world from Copenhagen Atomics. And we'll be using also a open source neutron transport software package called OpenMC. We're going to be doing things in four steps. Step one is downloading step files onto your computer. These step files form the building blocks of the geometry that we're going to be using. Basically, they form the model of the MSRE. Secondly, we're going to install some software. We're going to install OpenMC and CAD to OpenMC. Thirdly, we're going to run CAD to OpenMC to create a meshed geometry that OpenMC is able to use from the step files. And fourthly, we're going to run OpenMC to see if our reactor is able to go critical or not. That means, can it sustain a chain reaction or can it not? All the files you need to run the MSRE and follow this tutorial are available in the description below. Okay, so let's get cracking. First of all, we need to get the step files to our computer. These live on Google Drive, or they don't live there, they're just there, which anyone can download. We've made them publicly available. So this is what I'll do. I'll go here and I'll first download the control rod step file. I'll download the core step file and the pit step file. And these will be available on my computer just in a little bit. So I head on over to my terminal and I copy these files from my download directory to my simulation directory. And as you can see here, they're now available here. Unsurprisingly, the core step file is the biggest one. That's just where all of the little fiddly bits are. So that's what we need here. That was step one, getting the step files onto our computer. The next step is to install a bunch of software on our that we need on this computer. So I use, for this tutorial, I use a program called Micromamba that is designed to help manage in software installation environments such that you don't clutter your main environment of your system with a lot of things. I'll just create one of these environments and I'll tell it to use a particular version of Python that I tend to like. It's not too new, it's not too old, so 3.9 seems to be a good choice. This is what I'll do, and as you can see, things are now happening, and we're installing this Python environment where we are able to install a lot of other software later on. And that's gonna take a little 2 minutes or so to do so. Here something happens. We just tell it to confirm that. We could, in fact, do so by telling it to, given the option dash y, which means that we implicitly accept all of the changes that we just told it to do. And so now we're done. And as this command tells us, we need to activate this, this environment in order to use it. So we do that. And we can now see in brackets down in the left-hand corner that we are in fact inside this environment. Now, I will install some software that we need. We will install MOAB, which is a database for storing triangles or other mesh objects. We will install OpenMC, which is the package that we use for neutron transport. I will install the newest version of it, that's 0.14.0. And I will also make sure that installs version of it which has DAGMC enabled. That's what enables OpenMC to actually run on a CAD-based geometry made out of triangles. What we also need to do is to install a GL library called libglue. So I'll just do that and I'll make sure to remember to accept the changes right away by using dash y. That also takes a little bit of time because now the package manager has to figure out what kind of dependencies do we have and how do they all fit together. And so, since we did the dash y thing, it just started right away to install stuff. Those perceptive of you can see that installed, in fact, also OpenMPI, which means that we're able to run OpenMC in parallel using several nodes so that you can go much faster, or at least so much faster as to the number of nodes that you have. OpenMC is pretty good at this. This kind of problem is generally known as embarrassingly parallel, which means that the speed up is almost one. So, the next thing that we need to do is to install the meshing tool, CAD to OpenMC. We will use pip to install that. That's a different package manager which works well with the mamba, conda, micromamba environment. So you have to do it in that way, in that order. So I will simply tell pip install CAD to OpenMC. And then that also has a bunch of other dependencies which pip takes care of to install. And in the end, we end up with an environment that has all of the things that we need in order to run the meshing tool and also run OpenMC on the mesh geometry. So again, it takes a little bit of time, but not too bad. The next step is going to take a long time. So we're done. Now we have CAD to OpenMC, we have OpenMC, we have MOAB, we have all of the things that we need on this computer here in this environment without cluttering any of your system locations or anything like that. So what we need to do now is create a script that runs the meshing tool. That's pretty simple. I do that by just inventing a script called script.py. It's a Python script, so therefore it's called .py. First of all, I need to import CAD to OpenMC. I do this like so. Import CAD to OpenMC. I want to import the module, submodule called assembly. And to avoid typing too much, I'll do it, tell it to import it as AB. The next thing I need to do is I want to instantiate an object. Inside this, I will make an instance which stores the core. This is done like so. AB assembly, and I point it to the right step file. Like so. MSRE underscore core dot step. And then I tell the meshing tool to in fact run. I'll use a meshing backend called STL2. I'll tell it to merge geometries. And this is important when you have geometries which have surfaces that abut each other. For instance, the salt, which is one object, abuts all of the graphite stringers that form the moderator of the MSRE, and therefore they share surfaces, and then merging becomes important. So this will do. And the last thing we need to do is to tell it where to put the resulting geometry. I'll put that in core.h5m. So I need to do that two times more, but not for the core. I need to do it for the pit in which the core lives. And here I just copy paste because I really want to do the same thing once more. And I, in fact, copy-paste another time to do the control rods. I do the same thing where I, instead of pit, I write control rod. And lastly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell CAD to OpenMC to merge the pit and the core, so that will be one single reactor H5M file consisting of all the geometry that pertains to the reactor. I will not merge the control rod because I want the control rod to be its own entity that I can move in relation to the reactor core. Also, the MSRE had three control rods that you could move in the, independently. And therefore, I don't want to merge the control rod just yet. I want to include them as separate objects in our simulation run. Now, merging, that's being done by a function call inside the AB module or in the assembly module. And I simply give it a list of the things that I want to merge. And then I tell it where to put the resulting file. And I do this like so. I tell it to that I want to create the msrereactor.h5m file from these two other files. Don't worry about it, the other files will be generated and they will be present on your system, so you can certainly use them if you want to. Now, all I need to do is in fact save this file and run it through Python, because I have all the things installed that I need to do. So I simply write Python script.py and then I wait. In my computer, it takes approximately 2 hours to run this full circle. If you have a faster computer, then that's gonna go faster. Please remember that if you do other geometries which are not as complicated as this model of the MSRE, then this is going to be much faster. In fact, in experience tells us that most of the time we get meshing run timings or run of about a couple of minutes to, if it's a big thing, then about 10 minutes or so. Most of the time it's much faster than that, but for a realistic reactor model, it's a few minutes, generally speaking. And finally, we're done. You can see there has been a lot of output on the screen here. But if we look at the last 6-7 lines here, we can see that we have assembled a MSRE control rod.h5m file. There has been a VTK file created. That's useful if you want to look at, view this generated 3D file from using, for instance, a VTK enabled viewer like ParaView, for instance. There are others available. I tend to like ParaView, but that's just my personal preference. We can also see in the last three lines that we have created a file called MSRE Reactor. Remember, that was where we merged the core and the pit together and called it Reactor. That's just the way it is. We've been calling it. We can take a look. These files are here. The last five H5M files. Now what we need to do is create a script that runs OpenMC. And here I've made something in beforehand, which one can take a look at. I'll open it in my favorite editor and go to the top of the file. This is again a Python file that controls the running of the OpenMC. And we'll go through it very, very quickly here. So you have a bunch of import statement importing various bits and pieces of OpenMC. And then the first section of it is simply material definitions. We define the salt, that's the fuel salt that we used, or that was used in the MSRE, at least the one incarnation of it. You can, for instance, notice there is some U235 here. All of the nucleolides that we need are present here, are defined here. So we also need some graphite, we need some iron or 8, that's a nickel-based alloy, which was used for some of the structure. We need helium, which was also used. We need some enconel, that's again a structural element or a structural alloy that's been used. Some stainless steel of a particular type. Here is something that's a bit interesting. That's the gadolinium oxide, aluminium oxide mixture that was used in the in the poisoning elements in the control rods. And we get concrete and so on and so on. And in the end, we tell OpenMC to use all of these materials that we have defined. Now, next step is the geometry. We define couple of variables with the file names in it, and then we define these DAGMC universe. These are a particular kind of universe in OpenMC that contain meshed data files. So we simply define two of those universes and somewhere to put them in. And we also define three different regions or cells that we can fill with the control rod universe. That means that we have three separate incarnations of the control rods. And we just position them according to some scheme here. That means that we can move them up and down depending on the numbers that have been defined here. We define some settings. You can see that we run 20 batches with 2,000 particles each. We use 5 inactive batches to start up. And we define measure things in tallies, just as you regularly do when you run OpenMC. And we also define some plots should you want to look at the geometry that you're simulating beforehand. And in the end, we basically tell OpenMC to run this. And so that's all there is to this particular file. So we will now actually tell Python to run that. And that's what needs to be done for OpenMC to run. So I'll just Python, msrecritical.py. And what's going to happen now is there is obviously some startup. OpenMC will display its an ASCII version of its symbol. And then OpenMC is going to load the data structures from these H5M files, basically loading all the triangles and putting them in a special structure that enables us to use accelerated ray tracing in our simulation steps. That takes a bit of time. Once that's done, first we do it for the core, and then we do it for the control rods. Remember that those two were separate. The next step, once that's done, we have all the triangles, we have all the geometry. The next step is then loading neutron cross-sections from a different database that correspond to all of the isotopes that we have defined, all isotopes, nuclides that we have defined in our materials. Now, once that's done, OpenMC starts transporting neutrons around in our scene, seeing what happens, basically tracing them and seeing what happens to them as you go along in a Monte Carlo kind of way. And once that's done, you take all of the batches of particles that you've run, you basically average that and figure out, and from there on, you can get a criticality number or K effective to see whether or not your reactor can sustain a chain reaction or if it cannot. If it's above one, then it actually creates more neutrons than it consumes. And if it's a below one, it consumes more neutrons than it creates. And therefore, if it's below one, the chain reaction will simply die out of its own. And so ideally, the K effective number would be exactly one, because then things would be able to run indefinitely. So, but this takes a little bit of time. First step, accelerating data structures on the actual geometry. Second step, loading neutron cross sections. Third step, actually doing neutron transport. And final step is collecting all of that data into a single number. And we're done with our 20 batches. And we can see here from the results in the bottom that the estimated K effective value or criticality number for the MSRE in this configuration, that with the control rods where they were at this point, is just above one, which means that this reactor in this configuration was indeed able to sustain a chain reaction indefinitely. If you found this tutorial useful and want to stay updated with more content like this, please don't forget to subscribe.